Welcome back to our laboratory. Well, today we're gonna talk about the quality of communist-made electronics. And of course, there are good historical examples. Many of you probably watched our last week episode about Robotron 1715M.
In the case you didn't, the key thing was that that computer was made in East Germany, basically by socialistic industry, but it has such a good quality that even after 30 years it's running perfectly and looks like new. But today you will see an exact opposite example, and it was produced during exactly the same period, but in the USSR. It is this thing. It is a Soviet SM6337 dot matrix printer for A4 format.
And you know, over the many years, through my hands passed a lot of Soviet and socialistic bloc-made electronics, and this thing actually is absolute winner in a nomination of worst quality I ever seen. And what is especially crazy that actually it is brand new. It has half of parts packed still in an original plastic, and maybe it had only one single test run.
And the issues start right here. Just look at this sticker. So this .02 in the end indicates that it was produced by the factory of control computers in the town of Orel in Russia. And it was intended for civilian consumer market, and a bit later I will come to why I actually underscore this very fact. It is compatible with Epson by commands, has two interfaces and a few built-in fonts, and was normally used with YES and AGAT personal computers. So, frankly speaking, technically it is nothing special, but it is very special in how it was made. So, when I unpacked it, I noticed that the casing looks, let's say, somewhat strange. Well, I guess it may be some dirt, so I cleaned it a bit, believing it is just a dust. But in fact, nothing changed, and it appeared that actually there are some fractions of dirt that were just imprinted into plastic during the production process. And the plastic composition was not really uniform, so it gives this notably strange texture. The stamping mold was also likely quite old or used, because there are many artifacts like this. Okay, happens, but in many places what has to be flat is just not flat at all. And then I took a look at the rear part, and there is even worse. Here is a thermal damage in some places, and there is extra plastic where it should not even be. Okay, here on the back we have two connectors, one for RS-232 and one for Centronics interface, but there are no cables included, you had to solder them on your own. Well, that actually was quite a common thing. Good that there is a power cable, but it has some strange brown spot. Well, I thought it is some sort of dirt, but no, this is a thermal damage. Jeez. But okay, the texture of the casing is rather a cosmetic thing, right? But some parts are just deformed, like this one which guides the paper when the print comes out. Just look at it. Then there is this awesome red cover for the printing mechanism, which is actually quite rare version, because normally for these printers they were orange. But even it has some damage marks, and actually once you take it out, you cannot fit it inside without a hard force applied. And then, let's call it control panel. There is this lead that covers the switches that define the interface which is active and also a mode of communication with computer. And it just doesn't hold at all. And above, there is this glue mark under the sticker, it had obviously some leak, and it just collected all the dust. It looks simply disgusting. And there are a few LEDs indicating power, malfunction and a connection status to the computer, and there are four buttons for printing quality, testing and the line mode. But they are marked with those stickers, and look at them. You know, it's like someone placed here a long sticker and then just cut what was not needed with the knife, leaving those quite visible marks. It's insane. You know, I mean,
I've seen everything, and I understand that the factory probably had some sort of bad molds that made this quite bad quality surface, but how ignorant someone should be not just to place a sticker correctly. It's crazy. And well, I guess right now to the comments will start to come people from one specific neighboring country that will say something like, how dare you to say such things about the Soviet Union, there was everything absolutely top quality and was the best ice cream. The problem is, I have with what to compare.
So, a couple of years ago I had a version of this very SM6337 printer, but it was for A3 format and intended for special use, which actually means for military forces or the KGB. And the most notable difference was its casing was made from 1 mm thick metal with a very, very good powder coating. And everything inside had really impressive quality, with a lot of precision parts used and high quality plastic. And it was packed in a large wooden box with shock compensators and silica gel bags inside. And it was stored for years in garage, but only one thing that was, you know, not in a good condition was the documentation. So, needless to say, I just plugged that military printer into wall socket, okay, I changed the tapes, but I easily made a print right away. You know, literally Soviet double standards in a nutshell. And the problem was that, like this, it was everywhere and with everything. And just, you know, to be fair, another example. In a Soviet time in Ukraine, they have been producing, here near Kiev, such electronic 21 programmable clock. It is actually quite a cool thing. It allows to connect various devices and switch them on or off according to the time program. And by the way, if you want a review of it, just write me in the comments. But look, here I tried to push the button. Well, they work same as they sound. And this is not just a poor design, it's ignorance, because the person would receive the same salary regardless of their effort. And we yet didn't look inside. Okay, let's do it. Well, a lot of foam rubber, which of course disintegrated over the years, but okay, that's expectable. But I guess those are supposed to be dust filters. My god. And here is the mechanism. Honestly, at the backstage I cleaned it and lubricated it as much as possible, but it still goes somewhat really hard. And I saw better examples of those printers, and it should move easily. Okay, let's insert the paper. I will rotate the drum because the handle is sealed in plastic, I do not want to unpack it. Wait a minute. I do not get. It looks that there is a... So, there should be such a long metal stripe below the drum with the springs, and it should guide the paper, but it is simply not here. Like, I don't know. Like, I simply cannot roll the paper around without helping with these fingers. How is possible? Oh, okay. And here we have two circuit boards arranged like a sandwich, and well, here are two capacitors damaged, but they will still work. But the thing is, the upper board is just hanging. I mean, it's touching with its solder layer what is under. And wait, here is this mount, it just fell down. So, this is what it's supposed to be, but the thing is, I inspected it, it is not secured, it holds just on three holes and there are no marks it was in any way sealed in them, so say the soldering iron or something like that. So, basically, you just kick the box and all that just flies away. You know, I have enough. Forgive me, please. I will not risk to turn this machine on. And you know why I wanted to show you this is to explain the difference in a visual way. Because sometimes I see in the comments come people from the West, sometimes quite young people, who praise the Soviet industry. And I mean, yeah, it's interesting to study the Soviet industry, but what they were producing was generally not good at all. And this is the very good illustration why those kind of Robotron computers we reviewed recently were considered a luxury thing, despite what was made in socialistic bloc often was a bit worse and their capabilities compared to some Soviet-made machines. Because East German, Czechoslovak, Polish, Bulgarian, Hungarian computers would just work. You would not stand over them like over the Soviet stuff. And this is why, like one of the reasons why the Soviet Union collapsed, all this great industry eventually went to decline, because it simply could not be competitive. Okay, I have enough for today, so this is it for today. If you want to find some really cool things about the Soviet technologies used in the Chernobyl exclusion zone, don't forget to check our Patreon page, the link you can find in the description below. And this is it for today, see you next time. So tell me, what do you think? I guess he wants to give you a chance.